Hello everybody, thank you for joining today's video. I would like to speak today about the current flow. So I think all of you are aware that AC current, you know, it's flowing on the surface, a DC current is flowing in a volume conductor, but what is happening in between? So the motivation actually came from a discussion I had with a power electronics engineer. So we were looking at the current flow inside the power electronics module, and you could see that during the switching, you know, at some point in time the current was looking like flat, but it was still flowing in regions where you would not expect it, because you know, these regions were basically switched off already during the switching time, but you could still see a current there. And the engineer said, I mean, look at your results, your time domain simulations cannot be correct, you are wrong, this is a DC current, the curve is flat, where the current is still flowing at these positions. And then I said, okay, look, the curve is flat, but it's still not DC, because the main point is how long is actually the current flat. And this is what I would like to demonstrate to you. So what I have is a very simple example, just two conductive bars and two ports. So this is like the excitation port, it drives a one voltage signal, and it's terminated by a 50 ohm, and I switch it on for 1 nanosecond and then keep it switched on for 1 microsecond, as you can see here. Then I switch it off, and this leads to this particular current. So these are the voltage signals obviously, and these are the current signals. They just point in the different direction, because you know, the orientation of the current will be like this. And now what's really interesting is we start looking at what's really happening to the current when we do the switching. So let's start first, let's say, during the switch on time. So let me disable this, let's go to our arrow plot. We are at 0 nanoseconds, so there is no signal. And now if I just moved into the time, so you can see now we are at 0.1 nanosignal. The nanoseconds, the signal has traveled over some distance, as you can see here. Clearly the current is mainly on the surface in between the positions of the port. That's exactly where it has been excited. That's 0.1 nanosecond. We can continue. So of course now it takes some time till the signal propagates. The current is clearly it's on the surface. What's maybe a little bit interesting, it's not only on the inner surface but also on the outer surface, but it's clear it's on the surface. So this is what you would expect. Skin depth tells you, you know, a high frequency current stays on the outside. But now let's take a look what's actually happening over the course of that time. And now I switch my monitor to something which is not as finely sampled as the one before. So let's go to time zero. This is now time zero, and I have a 20 nanosecond step, just, you know, to not have too many samples for the 1000 nanoseconds. And let's maybe change the view. I add a cut in here and I do a contour plot. So okay, after 20 nanoseconds obviously the current is on the surface. It's always a little bit tricky, you know, we have to change the scale a little bit, and we have to think about the fact this is the current density. So the sum of the current is of course constant, but the current density will change, as we will see. So let's go 40 nanoseconds. Obviously, you know, we see something like the current now, I mean, this corners, this very high densities, they become less, simply because now what's happening is that the current starts to diffuse into the conductor. It's also called the current diffusion, simply because you know, the skin depth is telling you like a high frequency field will not penetrate into the conductor. But now as we are keeping the voltage constant, we are somehow, let's say, changing the frequency to go down. I mean, that's kind of where you want to see it. Of course, physics happen in time domain. There is no frequency domain is a nice thing to, you know, to understand some effects, but actually what's happening in the time domain is that we're getting a kind of diffusion effect, and you can see it clearly that the current is starting to diffuse and we get more and more current inside the volume. But also what's clear now, let me ramp up a little bit so you can see Now the current starts to penetrate and starts to distribute in this conductor. But this is a effect, the diffusion effect will take some time. We are already now at 660 nanoseconds. Let me ramp up a little bit more. And obviously, even the curve has been now flat. Already we are somewhere around here. The curve has been flat for a, you know, what looks for a very long time in this plot is 660 nanoseconds. It's not a very long time. But looking at your plot, you would say, oh, this is a flat curve for a long time. This is a DC current. But that's not true. So it takes really time for the current to penetrate, and like after 1 microsecond, obviously if I crank up a little bit here, it's clear that there is not like a homogeneous distribution in the volume. It's still a big amount of the current flowing in this, in let's say in the flowing still close to the surface, and over the course of the signal it starts distributing into the conductor. So this is the current diffusion. I think it's worth to understand this. Please don't be confused by these corners. This is an effect from the simulation, how it's discretizing the conductors. So don't be confused by these corners. They are not. They are just a simulation artifact, let's say. But you can clearly see that there is this distribution of the current in the inside. And what's now interesting is actually what happens when we switch off the current, when we switch off the driving voltage, we let the current flow. Obviously, when we switch off the driving voltage, the current will not disappear immediately. There is still a current flowing through this metallic bars. So something has to happen to them. And this is something that I found very interesting as a result of my simulation. So now I'm at 1000 nanoseconds. That's exactly when I start switching off. And let's take a look at what's happening to the current in the cross section. Wow, surprising, right? Why do we see such a very complex distribution? Why it seems to us that there is, you know, there are two regions of the current, and if we now switch to an arrow plot, it becomes obvious. There are really two different regions, and you can see that inside the one conductor bar, the current is flowing in two different directions. And why is this the case? This is because, you know, the current remains in the bar. What happens when I switch off the signal? On the left-hand side, so on port 1, it's a voltage port, so when I switch it off, it's basically a short. But on the right-hand side, there is a 50 ohm resistor. So, we know all current will flow around the path of the least impedance. And because the impedance, or let's say the resistance, the 50 ohm are much higher than the impedance which can be, let's say the loop impedance inside one of the bars, it's lower than this 50 ohm. So what will happen is we get two current flow directions inside this bar. And when I switch the view, let's say, to a cut like this, it becomes really obvious. We have created now a loop inside these conductors, and the current will flow as long as it dies off. So this will happen due to losses inside this conductor. So I think a very, very interesting finding right here. And you can see, in, of course, not only on the current, but of course on the magnetic field, you can see also this kind of effect. Why it's happening like this? I told you, it's because mainly of this 50 ohm port. If I use a different setup, where I have now port 1 being a voltage source, as we have seen before, and port 2 being like a short, so it's 1E minus 6 ohm. And we now looked at the current. Obviously the current looked different. It's no longer, you don't get the current jump as quickly, because you know, the overall inductance of the structure is now governed, the overall impedance of the structure is now more governed by the inductance of the bars. Before it was more governed by the termination resistance, now it's governed by the inductance of the bars. So you can see, of course, you know, the current increases slowly due to the inductance, and then it dies off also much slowly, as we have seen in the case where the traces were terminated. But if we look at the distribution of the current, of course it's obvious now that it will not stay inside each bar, as we have seen before, what we will get if I go to like time 1000, not 100, the time 1000, what we get now after switching off the signal, there is no change in the distribution. Obviously, this loop going through both conductors is now the path of the least impedance, simply because this port has such a low resistance or such a low impedance. And you can see now, of course, again, the same effect. The current will flow as long as it dies off. But depending on the termination impedance, it's a very different behavior. So I hope you enjoyed this video. And next time you see a flat curve on a current looking like this, look at the timescale and don't call it immediately DC current. Thanks a lot for listening.